Yeah, you know, Execration, they tried to run away, but it was very difficult because you got the Senya constantly chasing you. You got you with the right timing of the Jeet Kune Do. It's not really going to be easy for Execration to run away. And at the fact that their crowd control specialists are actually being like eliminated, it wasn't really easy for them. Like the perfect timing of the Numinum Blast on that team fight actually created space for Cignal Ultra to dish out a lot of damage. Remember, they did not lose anyone.
Look at that, right? Tess just threw his shield up, gets knocked up, and Chaknu just putting pressure on to this attack, but the damage out from Eason is just enough. That Sonata has been popped, but apparently it did not burst anyone down. Desanya though, trying to zone out this Martis, and they were able to do so. Immortality already up for Tets, and this battle already being picked up by few. That is another mid lane turret down for the Silent Execration. Could this be it? Could this be the moment of our comeback?
Divine Judgment being pulled out though. There's a jump in. Here comes the clash happening.
Oh, no.
Look at that. Cignal Ultra, they did lose one. And now they're going to get one in return. But no, they actually lose three of your Cignal Ultra. And this is looking bad indeed. I mean, Execration, they could actually defend this though. Oh, look at that. Nice Jeet Kune Do there.
That hurts a lot.
That May gets bursted down as Execration have managed to defend this in the skin of their teeth.
They get to live another day, but looks like he uses also a nice sidestep from Eason. Nice run though, and now look at the bullets, but apparently he just decided to let it go. He was the only one alive there, but he was able to hold on to their advantage. So Cignal Ultra gets to live another day. Everything's even Steven now because they have the marksman damage, but at the same time, Pakbet is online.
Yeah, Pakbet is actually getting stronger and stronger as the match progresses. And Zapnu was able to dish out some damage as well during that team fight. And May was likewise able to defend that because of his abilities. So Cignal Ultra, they have to watch out. They cannot get overconfident because this was their mistake in their previous matchup. I mean, they actually overextended against Evos, but then because they had the Lord, but then they realized they underestimated the damage that Evos could actually provide. Oh, look at that,
oh,
however.
No. Right, Eason is right here. Use that Sonata, but Killing Spree going over to Martis. Zapnu almost gets bursted down. Pakbet was able to save his team member, but a monster kill going over to Grigia. Look at that way of the dragon from Fiu was able to get down this Noodles, and I got that bang, bang, bang. Look at the damage output onto this Chaknu. Gets bursted down, taken down by the Ring of Order, and now Zapnu, he's the only one right there. He gets bursted down. That is a lot of damage, but he was able to defend his base. Now two members of Execration, they are the only ones left alive, but there are also two members from Cignal Ultra alive as well, and Tets literally just came back to life.
Yep, this is the worrisome about Execration when you have Zapnu deploying that Martis. Cignal Ultra, they realize that Zapnu is actually becoming a threat in this game. And remember, he's got that Bounty Hunter emblem. That's going to rack up his itemization. The fact that he's been very helpful to shut down what Desenia or Fiu is capable of doing because of the fact that he could actually control it means that Cignal Ultra has to watch out. They can't be over-dependent. They can't be overconfident on the fact that they got this early lead. Yes, I get it. You got these items already onto Fiu and Desenia, but you have to be careful because if Zapnu can constantly surprise you anytime, it might not bode well at your favor.